Welcome to the Great Exodus series. My name is Michael and I'm the founder of Triple Grace and the Righteous Path Movement Foundation. And today, our topic in this series is there a pattern to the first Exodus? Is there really a pattern to the first Exodus? The first Exodus with Moses? Was Moses accepted by the Israelites when he came to tell them to come out of Egypt? Or was he rejected? Was he accepted by the Pharaoh at this time? Or had God to intervene? And is there a same pattern to the time of today? Do we see biblical plagues and judgments already in this world, so that we can compare it with the time just before the Exodus in Genesis? Do we see that? Is it here? Have we not seen since 2017 increasing biblical plagues that fall onto the earth? Red water, water that looks like blood, locust and Mecca, many other animal death, many other infestations in nations around the world. We have seen all that, except what we have not seen are yet the days of darkness and the death of the firstborn. So there is a true pattern. Now the same happened at the time of Moses. Moses was rejected by the Israelites when he came to tell them, we have to move out of Egypt. Most likely they were laughing about him, saying, why should we go? We have everything here, we can sit here. Now the same with you people. I know that you reject my idea of coming out of the world in Babylon. But the Father has told me to tell you to come out and to walk the path to Mount Zion. And he has told me that I have to gather you on the new altar of love, unity and support. And that's exactly what I will do. I will follow him. Because according to the pattern, even Satan will of course reject what we are doing. And he's doing that by many difficult things in our videos. Sometimes I cannot upload. Sometimes there's a lot of interference. Sometimes people are talking in the background because he sends them over so that everything gets stopped. I know, Satan is not willing to let you go. The same as Pharaoh was not willing to let the people of God go. There is the same pattern. So what happened afterwards? Moses was rejected by the Israelites. Then the Pharaoh refused to let the people go. What happened? The plague. Jesus and God intervened. And when the Father intervened, then the Pharaoh at the end had no other way than to let the people go. And the same we will see here. The next plague that will come will be more worse and more worse. And judgment will fall onto this earth. And then one day we'll say, oh, yes, I remember Michael. Michael was right from the beginning. Now let me see if I can find him so that I can join him on the path to Mount Zion. I hope at the time it will be not too late for you. And I hope that all of you will be escaping with the bride, because this will be the next. But the people who will be left behind, please come to me, join me and walk with me to Mount Zion. Because we will be raptured into paradise at the sixth seal. So do not worry that you cannot make it. You will make it. But you have to come out of the world and out of Babylon. You have to come out of the bondage and slavery that Satan has put you in. Forget about your career. Forget about your families even. Forget about your friends. And just come out and concentrate on the heavenly kingdom. On the Father, on Yahweh, on Yahuwah. On his only begotten Son Jesus, Yeshua HaMashiach, and follow us, walk with us towards the mountain. This mountain is not a mountain that you find in Israel. This Mount Zion will be the mountain that is carved without hands, that will be carved by Jesus at the time of the sixth seal, when he will come there. You read in Revelation 14 that Jesus is standing with the 144,000 on Mount Zion. This is not the Mount Zion in Jerusalem. There's a difference between that mountain and the Mount of Jerusalem. So please walk with us. Watch the videos. We have videos about Mount Zion up in our New Journey to Paradise series. And we have a lot of information for you. But please think about it. When calamity will strike, where will you hide? Where will you go? What will you do? We show you an open door that you can use, a new path that will lead to paradise. We can only show you that door, and we can tell you, please, walk with us through that door. But the path you will do with the Father and with Jesus alone. Be guided by the Holy Spirit. Pray over it. Find your walking partner, maybe an angel. For example, with me, I know the Archangel Michael is walking with me together. He appeared to me in a vision and he said that I should do not worry because he will be with me always. The same words, by the way, that Jesus used in the Bible. So it's very great if you have visions like that. And I hope that you also have visions and dreams about the heavenly kingdom, about what is coming in the future, that you can see where your path is guiding you. This might be different for other people, but for you, you will be guided, guided by the Holy Spirit, guided by the Spirit of wisdom. Just let them in. Do not be afraid of it. You have to walk in spirit and truth, not only by reciting Bible verses, but also by listening to the Holy Spirit and the Spirit of wisdom, so that you can walk the narrow path, not the broad path that everybody else is walking. Do not fall into the trap of the false grace people who say everything is done, there's nothing we have to do anymore, and we just wait for Jesus to come to pick us. You might be surprised if you are not going at all, not going with the bride and not going at the rapture into paradise. And then you will be here during the time of trumpets, when the 144,000 are working. And then it will be a terrible time. So please, if you are not part of the bride, and you cannot know this by now, only when you go with the bride, I'm very happy, of course. But if not, then come and join us. Join me and walk with me towards Mount Zion. I'm very happy and grateful that you're here with me in this series. And also, sometimes I'm rambling a little bit. Please listen to my thoughts that I will give to you. Pray over it. Everything what you hear on our YouTube channel, take to the Lord. Ask the Holy Spirit to give you guidance. Write down your dreams and visions that you have. Look at them. Think about it. Meditate about them. And then walk with us the narrow path towards Mount Zion, so that you can be part of the multitude clothed in white at the base of Mount Zion, that the Father will tell you, well done, son or daughter. And then he will rapture you into paradise. Or you will be sealed as 144,000 and will then continue your glorious work during the time of trumpets for the Father. No matter what it will be fantastic for you. So please join us and walk with us together. Establish a Society of the Rose in the nation. And if you have any question, then please mail them to me at triplegrace55@gmail.com. I am so grateful that you're here with me, and I love you all dearly. You are all my brothers and sisters, and nobody is elevated, and we are all equal. Equal in the sight of the Father. We are all the children of Zion. So let us start now, come out of the world in Babylon, and walk towards the mountain, so that we can reach Zion in time for the great harvest. Thank you that you're here with me for this video. I love you all dearly. May God bless you and your family abundantly. And I will see you again tomorrow. Maranatha.